Hello everyone, welcome to our channel IAC Steno. We are starting the passage at speed of 80 word per minute. Start. Mr. Chairman, I rise to support this resolution because this matter has to be considered and reconsidered as planning goes on. Right at the beginning, I must say that this village industry, despite all brave talk on the part of the planning commission and the government, has been given a back seat by the planning commission. And I think a lot has to be done in order to reorientate the entire approach with regard to village industries. I generally agree with much of what has been said by the two speakers who have preceded me, and I should like to add a few suggestions to what they have said. Now, even when we were fighting the British, one of the indictments against the British rule was that it led to the ruination of our village and cottage industries. This criticism was absolutely justified, and the meaning of it was not fully seen at that time, perhaps as it is seen today after independence. We have embarked on a policy of industrialization of the country, but in an underdeveloped economy like this, where we have got nearly 82% or a little more of the population living in the villages, you cannot have rapid industrialization merely by starting heavy industries or even medium industries in the urban areas and towns, whether they be in the public sector or in the private sector. They are, of course, important, and the development of such industries must be on a far bigger scale. This is what we stand, but at the same time, we must embark on a policy of industrialization of the rural areas today. There was a time when capitalist economists almost took it for granted that with the development of capitalism, rural industries must go, and in fact, in Europe, in the beginning of the 20th century, we saw in Germany and other places many small scale and village industries going out of existence as capitalism grew. Monopoly capitalism, which is growing in our country, also has a tendency to crush the small and medium industries, let alone village industries. The moment rural economy is drawn into the orbit of capitalistic market, the tendency is there and the laws operate for the decline of the rural industries of the type that exist. Now, this process is there in our country. Artificially, we are trying to maintain some. In the rural areas, you have nearly 3.5 million new job seekers every year. Rural industry must be viewed from the larger angle of industrialization of the country, from the point of its employment potentialities, and also from the point of view of raising the standard of living in the country. Yesterday, here, the Prime Minister was saying that unless agriculture looked up, national income would not go up still higher and the standard of living would not go up. I entirely agree, but then in the rural sector of our economy, we must develop simultaneously the other sector, that is called the rural industrial sector, for promoting rural industries on a larger scale. That is not being done. Now, I found in our country and we heard complaints that these industries were not getting help. The artisans are not only not taken care of, but they are sent to their doom by the government. In many places, I found that in the south also, many fine handloom industries which should be nursed by the government and developed with all the attention and care are allowed to go out of existence. Therefore, it needs a serious rethinking on the part of the Commission as to how can we set about this task. It is not just a question of supplementing something, it is a question of developing a dynamic sector in our economic life in the countryside, because we cannot envisage a situation where industries will be developing only in the towns and the problem will be solved. Bigger industries and certain other medium industry will create, certainly develop and should develop in the towns. At the same time, small industries through cooperative, state sector, individual, enterprise and through artisans should also develop in the countryside. This is how we can set up the rate of industrial progress of the country. These industries can cater to the consumers' need to a considerable extent, relaxing our pressure on imports and also helping the development of certain vital industries apart from providing employment. The employment question is very important. Now, at the time of the last general election, the gentlemen of the Congress party issued a manifesto written by Prime Minister Nehru in which they have said that unemployment would be reduced in the course of the next 5 years. At that time, it was 53 lakhs. Now, when they went to the third general election, the unemployment has gone up to 90 lakh, and we are told by the Planning Commission that in the course of this 5-year plan, it would have gone up to 12 million. Stop.